Okay, we're gonna do one more practice to get us ready for the final. And we're gonna draw, turn it this way for a second. Equidistant triangle, so you wanna make one side, you can measure it, either with centimeters or inches or millimeters. So this one's 40 millimeters. Oops. No, 40 centimeters. 40 millimeters. Let's see if I have inches on here. This one doesn't have inches. Isn't the same size. Oh well. Has 50 at the bottom. Okay, so make a triangle, then a circle. If you made an equidistant triangle, then each side would be the same. You can draw a C first and a backwards C. Then make an arc. With the top of the arc the highest, and connect it. And then here I made a castle shape. So over, horizontal, vertical, horizontal, vertical, horizontal, vertical, horizontal, vertical, horizontal, vertical, and connect it at the bottom. So the same placement, I forgot to draw my line first. Draw the line in the middle of the paper for the horizon line and your vanishing point. Okay. Then your three dots. So one on the bottom left, bottom right, and top. Well, that's going to be a hard one. And the circle. On the side. Actually, you better not draw those. I'll show you how to do that. So, from the bottom left of the triangle, connect that one. Connect the two dots. And the top one's going to be just a little skinny one. And then from the side of the circle, to the vanishing point, and this side of the circle to the vanishing point. And from the top of the arc, or the left side of the arc, top left, and the bottom of the arc, the right. And the bottom of the castle shape to the vanishing point, the top of the castle. I can put dots there to show you. So dot, 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 and one on the right side and one on the left. Another orthogonal line to the vanishing point, another one to the vanishing point. This one stops when it gets there, it keeps going. That one to the vanishing point, and that one to the vanishing point, and that one to the vanishing point. Okay, and then I decide how far I want it to go back. So for my castle, I'm going to make this vertical line parallel with this vertical line, this horizontal line parallel with this horizontal line, this one parallel with that one. Okay, this one goes back. Oops. And ends here. This one's going to be the same distance, but this vertical goes to here. And this one goes the same as this one. It's horizontal as like that one is, and vertical like this one is. That's a complicated one. Then erase the orthogonal lines. I go back to the vanishing point. And I'll do this with pen so you can see it better. This is all one point perspective. Which is how architects do their buildings. Remember last year when we did architecture? If you were at Laurel Mountain last year? Okay, then we'll make this curve right here. There's no straight lines except at the bottom here, so you have to make this one curve parallel to this curve. So they have to go the same direction. So it's the same curve. And then erase my orthogonal lines and go back. And this one curves this way. Okay, same thing with my triangle. This line has to be parallel with this line. And the diagonal line and the horizontal line has to be parallel with the horizontal line. Erase the orthogonal lines. Like something like spaceships you could do. Oops, that wasn't very straight. And then this curve has to be the same as this curve. And then erase my orthogonal lines. So there you have one point perspective shapes that create depth. You see them?